Now, the Lakers are in a very interesting spot because now all their players are being launched, obviously, into the stratosphere of, you know, of attention making, but still remaining in the headlines is LaVar Ball. Now, LaVar Ball back in the headlines talking about it's Lonzo Ball's team, and Lonzo didn't go to Cleveland. LeBron came here. We'll play the clip for you guys. He was on Power 106 in Los Angeles. Take a look.
That's not LeBron's team.
It's not LeBron's team.
He ain't homegrown.
LaVar.
You can say what you want, but we know what it is.
I told you. What is
Lonzo
it?
Lonzo didn't go to Cleveland. Lonzo didn't go to Cleveland. LeBron came here to L.A. We already over here.
What can LeBron learn from Lonzo?
He can't learn nothing from Lonzo. And Lonzo can't learn nothing from him. What they got to do is win together. They
right.
both know how to win, so that's the main thing. Ain't about no skills and how you going to finish a game. It's winning.
Have you had a conversation with LeBron? Maybe a phone text combo?
I haven't had anything. LeBron is doing his thing, getting acclimated to L.A. You know, and I'm doing my thing, building my empire. So
yeah.
I'm probably going to run into him probably at the first game or something
Did
like that.
Did you get word early on that LeBron was coming to L.A. before anyone else?
Get word. I don't even know he was coming to L.A.
I know you called it. You called it,
L.A. LeBron. I mean, it only makes sense. But don't act like it's a big deal. If you're going to make a business move, I mean, after basketball, we're going to set up a little shop in Cleveland.
Right.
I think the worst thing about that clip, you know, despite whatever LaVar Ball, you know, enjoys saying, he said that Lonzo has nothing to learn from LeBron James. Now, if there's a player in the NBA that I would want my son to play with and also had to learn to be a team leader under, wouldn't LeBron James be the number one guy on that list by a considerable margin, maybe followed closely number two by Steph Curry? Lonzo has a ton of stuff to learn from LeBron James. You know, how to win a playoff game, how to win a primetime game, how to be a leader of a franchise, how to carry yourself both on and off the court. I actually think Lonzo and LeBron have a decent amount in common in terms of their overall personalities. I think Lonzo is a little bit quieter than LeBron, but to say that your son has nothing to learn from LeBron James is very, very strange. But let me know in the comment section below, whose Lakers team is it? Type LBJ for LeBron, type Tipple B for Lonzo Ball. Personally, it's LeBron's, obviously, but it might also not be either of theirs. It's Magic Johnson's team. If there's one player who, or one person in the NBA who can actually outsign LeBron, it's probably Magic Johnson. And apparently Ice Cube agrees with me. Ice Cube says, quote, it's Magic's team. Don't bow down to LeBron. He also said he loves how the team is built. Cube also said to not worry about LaVar and to just let Lonzo play and to watch him on the court. I agree with Ice Cube. Totally agree with him. This is Magic Johnson's team. Until LeBron James actually plays a full season for the Lakers, like, it's still Magic's team. Like, this is a team that he put together. This is his roster that him and Rob Pelinka intricately put together. It's similar to when LeBron went to Miami for the first time. Obviously, the NBA is much different than it was when he went there for the first time, but the first year that LeBron was in Miami, it wasn't really his team yet. It was Dwayne Wade's team. I mean, Dwayne Wade at that point was already one of the best players in the NBA. They had already won an NBA Finals. Obviously, LeBron coming in, you know, they ended up sharing it, but I don't think this is LeBron's team yet. I think it will obviously end up being his team, but for now, until he actually plays, it's Magic's. And I don't think this needs to be some crazy back and forth tug of war between Lonzo and LeBron. And honestly, I don't think they look at it like that either. So for now, it's Magic Johnson's team, and we'll leave it at that. Let's go to Kyle Kuzma's comments that came out yesterday saying, quote, a lot of people are underestimating us. This season is going to be fun. He also said that change can be a good thing and that he's excited to figure out the team chemistry. He also wanted to point out that they are not the only team that has to figure out new chemistry with their guys. He said, look throughout the Western Conference. There are a lot of new teams with a lot of new players that need to get their team chemistry in order. He also said that he was annoyed that he thinks that the team is starting to be ruled out simply because they're young. Look, I agree with you, Kyle Kuzma. I think people are absolutely underestimating the Los Angeles Lakers. I don't understand why. There is a ton of talent on this team, a ton of talent at every single position. Guard, shooting guard, wing, power forward, down low as well. There's talent all over the place on this Lakers team. And oh wait, they also have the best player in the NBA. So why wouldn't this team make it to the playoffs and win 50 games? The fact that there are people out there that don't legitimately think that the Lakers, who just got LeBron James, is not going to make the playoffs, you people are crazy. You people are nuts. I know he's in the West now. LeBron went to the finals 8 consecutive years in the East, and you think he's not going to make it to the playoffs at all in his first year in the West? How does that make any sense at all? Like, did we just forget that LeBron James in game one of the NBA Finals dropped 51 points and the Cavs lost? Come on, this team is going to be just fine. They're definitely going to make the playoffs. People are absolutely underestimating the Lakers. I don't understand it.